Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel again, General Technology Knowledge. Today I would like to show and share about PLC S-Van 300 CPU 314C2PN/DP about the analog output. In the previous video, we already learned about analog input, yes, and we already tested and wiring the diagram from PLC to test with the standard source milliamp, yes, and already setting, yes. So today we will continue to analog output. I will explain for easy to understand. First, let's go to see the CPU, yes. For analog output card, it also built-in in the CPU, the same as analog input also. And here is the drawing, wiring diagram, yes. There are two channels for analog output with this CPU, okay, and this is a drawing diagram. You see the channel number 0, AQ, yeah, or AO. You see, actually the current and voltage we can select here, yes, select here. If we would like to use the volt, we can use the volt. If you would like to use the current, we can also use the current, okay? Actually, these two terminal, A it mean that plus, and V it mean that minus. When we connect to some electrical devices, example drive, VFD, or some electrical devices that use milliamp or volt, okay, and I will use Schematic Manager software for connect to the PLC for communication. Download, yes, download the program, and I will set IP of my PC 192.168.0.253, and this is the default IP address of the PLC. 192.168.0.1 and connected we are RJ45, or we can call LAN cable, okay, and here is the setting we can set. I will show in the software, yes. So let's go to test with software. In this section I will connect with the HMI for this signal, and I will use the WinCC flexible for connect also, okay. So let's go to our software. So here is the software, Schematic Manager and WinCC flexible. In here I use the version 5.6, and for WinCC I use WinCC flexible 2008 ZB page fine, okay. So first let's go to Schematic Manager, and let's check the IP address. We can use like this IP config, yes. You see here is the IP address of my computer, because I already manual, yes, here. Actually, it doesn't show like this, so we need to manual. And create a new folder, yes, for a new project. Example, S-Van 300 AO. Or AQ, Okay. So create new project. S7 300 AO. Yes. And browse to a folder that we already created. Yes, the folder. And click OK. So first, we need to create the station, yes, symmetric station 300. And here we can rename example AO. Yes. And double click, yes, hardware configuration. Let's go to tab S1 300. Go to rack and rail, yes, drag and drop. Yes, and then we will create the power supply like this. Example, we can do like this, but the actual real work, we can compare with the nameplate of the power supply. Yes, before insert to the rack, right? So the next, we'll create the CPU. Right now, I will use this CPU. 314C2PN /DP, yes, and here's the last version 3.3, yes, firmware version. And you see here is the default of IP address for this module, so we can click OK. Yes, for this card, yes, you see AI 5 / AQ or AO 2. It means that in this module of CPU, it already built in 5 channels of analog input and 2 channels of analog output. Okay, so here is the address. It will start from PQW, yes, we can say PQW 800 until PQW 803. Okay, so here double click here, here is the address. Actually we can put the manual mode, but in this section I will use the auto address first, that it already maps on the semantic manager. Okay, so here is the input we already learned in the previous video. Yes. Yes. Previous video we already set this one. But today we will focus this tab. Okay. For this tab, we can select also if electrical device this that use V, it means that volt 0 to 10 volt or plus minus 10 volt, you can select V. Okay, for in this section I will choose I because I have the standard saw or a meter or my electrical devices used 4 to 20 milliamp. So I will use current. Yes. Okay, so after finish the setting, we can click OK and then save and compile the project. Yes, and let's go to here, go to option to set PC interface. It means that check the communication between our PC with the PLC, okay or not. Okay, so let's go to this network. Yes, active diagnostic and then click test. Yes, it's so like this. It means that we can communication between our PC with the PLC. okay, so click OK. And actually we can use the command prompt and ping 192.168.0.1, right, ping from our computer to the PLC. Okay. It show like this. It means that we can connect. Yes. So let's go to here and then click download. Select all and then click OK. And take time a little bit for communication before we can download. Okay. So wait a moment. Actually, we need to know the voice link. It's very important. Yes, here. It's very important. If we don't know the voice link diagram, we cannot connect with our electrical devices. Okay. So it is very important for a diagram of this module. Okay. So here we it found one CPU 192.168.0.1, right? So we can click view. Yeah, here and click OK, yes, and download. Yes, download. Okay. And let's go to check the program. Yes, we can write program sample for test. So double click on OP1 and I will choose the letter. Actually, we can use section take function block. Yes, and letter. So in this section, I will use letter. So here we can comment. Yes. Test analog output of PLC S7-300 with LAN cable. Yes. Okay, so here we can move. Yeah, we can use move. So move. Yes, we can use move to address, right? So PQW 800, yes, like this, because the hardware configuration is start from PQW 800, right? So we can use 800. Yes. And I will use the move. Yes. Example from word. So this one, I can use the VW0, or we can use VDW. So the input will be like this. Yes. You can freeze F1. Yes. Or check the input. So we can move. Yes. MW, yes. Example MW 0, yes, to the channel number 0. And we can also copy and use MW example 100 to PQW 2, right? Channel number one, yes. So save our project and download to the PLC and then we can online, yes. Decimal, yes. So MW, actually we can test like this. MW 0, right? So here we can choose 0. Yes. 0, the milliamp will show 4 milliamp, right? And if we set to the maximum, yes, I will change to decimal, maximum around 2.7684, right, around this, yes. The milliamp will show around 20 milliamp something, yes. And for the channel number 2, sorry, channel number 1, we can also MW. MW100, yes, decimal also. If I set 0, it will show 4 milliamp, yes. And if I set the maximum 2.7684, yes, it will show 20 milliamp, okay. So we can write the touch panel to set this point also, right? Example convert from 0 to 100%, yeah, and the output will start from 4 to 20 milliamp, yes, like this. Okay, so let's go to our software WinCC Flexible to create the sample screen, yes. So open the WinCC Flexible and create the empty project, yes. I will use the panel, yes. Touch panel, example this one, yes. So first let's go to a connection, yeah, to set the connection. It's very important because we need to use the connection first, yeah, to configure the connection first before we can online and simulation with the CPU or PLC, okay. So example connect AQ, yes, and I will choose the semantic advanced 300, 400, right? So many driver that we can connect, yeah. Example SVN 200 or some protocol, Alantrale, GE, yes, Omron, yes, many brand that we can use. So right now I will use the semantic SVN 300, 400, okay. And we can command connection for test with analog output, yes. Okay, and first we need to use the internet, right? Because right now we connected with the RJ45 or LAN cable, yes. And here is the IP address of computer. So 192.168.0.2. Okay, IP my computer 253, right? Okay, 253, yes. And here is the IP address of PLC, yes. So 192 dot 168.0.1. Okay. It's very important if we not configure the IP address, we cannot simulation with the module. Okay. So let's click save and save to desktop also and go to our project. Yes. HMI of HMI HU, yeah, like this. Okay, after create the connection, let's go to text. Yes. So I will use the set point, yes. Set point CA0, right? Set point for channel 0. So the data type is word, right? So start from MW0, yes, for channel number 0. You see here, MW0 is channel number 0. And the second one for channel number 1, right? So start from MW100, yes. It is just example. If we know the concept, so we can do everything, okay? So in this video, it's just example for how to test, yes. So after that, we can go to screen, yes, and go to the text file. Yes, so we can write something. Example, test AQ with CPU 314C 2PN / DP. Okay, like this. And we can go to property, go to text, and we can center and middle, and we can adjust the font. Yes. To be like this, just to be small a little bit, yes. Okay, we can adjust. Okay, so if we would like to set point from touch screen to the PLC, we can use the IO file, yes. So click and then drag and drop, yes. So here we can use the format, yes, middle and the font maybe 18, yes, and go to the general and format. This actually we can use example 999.9, right? Okay, like this. So here we can choose the text, yes. Go to text and then go to MW0 and click here, and we can scaling. So when the PLC is, yes, when the HMI is 0 to 100%, the PLC will show, yeah, will set the PLC, will show the 27648 something, yeah, example like this. So we can save and we can write here. It is the input, right? Dot name. So it is the PQW800. Yes. go to property, go to font. I will change this one to black, and this one to white, this one to green, and the yes, I will choose a white, yes, like this. So can save and can simulation for test, yes. Okay, so let's test for channel number 0, yeah. Example 10%, yes. Yes, 10%. And this is a 100%. Yeah. Okay, when I set 0%, yeah. Let me show the milliamp. Yes, you see right now the milliamp is show 4, around 4 something, 399 milliamp. So if I adjust to example 50%, it will show 12 milliamp actually, yes. But this one show around 11.9, yes. If I set 35%, yes, you see around 16 milliamp, yes, and 100%, it will show 20 milliamp, okay, right? So we can use like this for config with the HMI for test, right? Because actually it will set point from 0 to 100% or something, so we need to scale the text, okay. For PQW82, yes, we can also do like this. Yes, go here and then just change this one to one, right? This channel. And actually, this one we can write percent, right? So percent. And we can change to the yellow or some other color. Okay, like this. Yes. We can save and we can simulate again. Yes. Yes. So if I set 0.20, this one to zero also, you see here, is zero. Please wait a moment, I will connect to the channel number one. Yes. Yes, right now you see the channel number 1 is show 4 milliamp, yes, because I set 0. If I adjust to 50%, yes, 50%, yes, 100%. PQW 82, right? PQW 100. So we need to scale also, yes. Input and then scale, yes. Go here and then click here to scale. So PLC will 278648, yes. And we can simulation again. Yes. You see here E0, yes. And the milliamp will show around 398, yes. 3.98. If I set to 50%, yeah, you see the milliamp is adjust to 12 and 75, yes, 16, 100%, yes, around 20 milliamp, right? So this is a instruction how to test the analog output of PLC SVN300 CPU 314C2PN/DP. We are a LAN cable and use the software Simatic SVN Manager and WinCC Flexible. So thank you very much for watching my video. If everyone have any question, please drop comment under my video. I will reply soon. And I would like to request all of you to like, share, and subscribe my channel also to get more notification and more new videos that I will create step by step. I hope this video will help everyone to test the analog output for PLC SVN300. Okay, so in this time, I would like to say thank you very much and also sorry if I have mistake. And see you next videos. Bye bye.